us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord, a word from the Lord, just one word from the Lord.
Themselves at you don't mean you got to catch you.
All right.
They gave him all of these wives for free, and he became so successful, and this was a business mindset. You can understand why he did what he was, because he was so driven for success. Oh, and he had all the gifts and abilities and people in the right places to advise him, to the point that he spread his kingdom. And when he spread his kingdom, he compromised God. All success is not good success.
All success
is not good success, because God had told him in his word, hey, don't take many wives.
Right. Yes, sir.
That's what he said. One theologian said Solomon sinned in 5 different ways. He engaged in polygamy. He violated God's command against marrying pagans, which ultimately led him to his own apostasy. He collected huge amount of horses or large chariots. And number 4, he gathered vast amounts of wealth. And that's why we have the text showing you what he did. He says in verse 2, and they were from nations, these women that he took, they were from nations about which the Lord had told the Israelites, you must not intermarry with them, because they will surely turn your heart against their gods. So turn your hearts to their gods. Nevertheless, Solomon held fast to their love. Oh, Solomon, not only was he into the success of stuff, but he loved it. Some women always ask, why do men cheat? They cheat because they can. Let me say that. It's not that deep. It's not that deep. They cheat because they can, and they choose to do it because they love it. Can't nobody make a man feel like a man, especially a young woman that's smiling in his face and saying, oh, you sure did preach good today, preacher. That's all right, preacher. Hey, you know, wives tend to be professional. Wives will tell you, your tile is crooked. You mispronounced that word. I told you that word was pronounced.
Oh, Lord.
So Solomon did it. He loved it. Oh, he loved it. And God had warned him that if you get too many women, you run after too many women, it's going to turn your heart against me.
That's what he said. Yeah. Amen.
Away from God. And that's why it's hard to get men in the church, because they're too busy running women. That's why it's hard to get men in the church. They're too busy running women.
My Lord.
And as they're running women, they don't think nothing about God.
My Lord.
That's deep, isn't it?
All right.
That's deep. That's what the word of God. That's why he warned the king about this. He warned the king. Verse 3 said, and he had 700 wives of raw birth. That's
right.
Treaties that he had.
Right.
All those different treaties. And then he had 300 concubines or girlfriends. And his wives led him astray.
Yeah.
If you don't have your love life right, it will lead you astray. Oh, that's why it's hard to get a lot of single women up in the church, because they're too busy running after the man, trying to put a man in God's place as opposed to keep God in his place. Oh, I know I said something. God says he'd rather you be single and I be in the place grace of God then for you to compromise your beliefs and put that man in the place of God.
All right.
Many single women will compromise their beliefs, try to sleep with the brother to get him.
Mm-hmm.
There's only one problem. If he's running women, you just one of me. So if you really want to keep them, you probably need to just be obedient to the word.
Amen.
I know I said something next.
Amen.
Because these kinds of relationships and intermingling and searching and running out to love and marriage and all of that will lead you astray to apostasy.
Oh, Lord.
This man who was the wisest man ever to live because he didn't have his love life right. He went astray. Boy, that is
the
wisest man to ever to live.
Say that.
Let's let us know that we're all vulnerable.
Yes,
we don't obey the word of God.
Right.
We all can fall from God's grace.
Yes.
Say to your neighbor, neighbor,
neighbor.
Oh, neighbor,
oh neighbor,
get your love life right.
Get your love life right.
Love God more than any man.
All right,
any
amen.
Woman.
Yes, sir.
Even more than your children.
All right.
Your address, what's up?
Hello.
Get a book.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Am I right about it?
Yes, sir. Amen.
So, don't put man in the place of God. Don't put marriage or the pursuit of love in the place of God or therein after. And also, don't put money in the place of God.
All right.
I mean, sometimes the word seems to contradict itself. Now I'm going to bless you, but I don't want you to collect silver and gold. Not too much of it. Thank you, sister.
All right.
It's not that you can't have any.
Yeah.
Hello?
You
don't let it have you.
Hello.
Yeah. See,
amen.
When you get that successful, when the stuff start owning you.
My Lord. Say that.
Yeah. That's when you need to let it go and simplify your life.
Yeah.
Some folks, at the sound of my voice, didn't make it to the service today because they're too busy washing their car.
No, Lord. Yes, sir. I know you're right. Amen.
They couldn't make it to church today because they was too busy taking care of that house yesterday.
My Lord.
Cleaning it out. Making it look good.
Oh, Lord. Well,
it's true. Woke up in the morning, I'm hurting. This big house. Don't put money in the place of God. The text says, when you enter the land, the Lord is giving to you. It says in verse 17. He must not accumulate large amounts of silver and gold. He must not accumulate large. So he said, preacher, it's okay to have a small amount. I just read what the text says, large amounts.
Right, yeah.
We can transfer this over to New Testament terminology in Matthew 6:19-21. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moths and rust destroy, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where moths and rust do not destroy, and where thieves do not break in and steal. And this is the key, verse 21.
That is it.
For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also.
Yeah, Lord.
On the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.